Hey, hey. Happy Monday, it's motivation Monday.
Oh, they're bringing water in Monday.
That's crazy. Hello guys, it's Monday. Wow, look at the beautiful calm sea. Water is life, guys. Water is life. Yes, it is. You know, have you ever stopped to think about it? If you don't have water, how would we survive? Water is in almost everything. You can't disagree with me. Water is in almost everything. Come on, baby. Water is life. To make your clothes, you need water. Somehow, somewhere along the production line, you need water. Food, you need water. When you're eating, if you ever try to eat dry food and your mouth is dry, just imagine how insipid that tastes. You need some water to churn that food in your mouth. Oh yes, water is life. Hi Sister Andy. Hi Juan Richardson. Welcome to Ladies Uplifting and Inspiring. It's a beautiful Monday, and you know what time it is. It is Motivation Mondays. What motivates you? What is your mood today? What's your mood today? What motivates you? What is your mood today, guys? It's Monday. See that water behind me, guys? Yes, I'm at the beach. Water is life. Hi, Tanis. Welcome to Motivation Mondays. I'm just gonna drop a few gems with you today to let you know the importance of water, how important water is, right? Do you ever wonder when God made this place called Earth? Water was already in existence, right? Water was like the only thing that was in existence. If you don't believe me, go and read Genesis 1. Okay, I can't remember the exact verse, but if you don't believe me, just go and read Genesis 1. Water was already in existence in this world. And if I'm not mistaken, it was the first thing. You know, when he was making heaven and earth, before he divided heaven and earth with the firmament, water was, the body of water was everywhere. And he made dry land to couple with water so that we could live on dry land, right? Water is so much important. All right, and how many glasses of, oh, look at the fish. Oh, I just missed him. I just missed him. Ooh, ooh, I just missed him. You missed him too. Yes. He came up. Where's Malachi? Put on your slippers, sweetie. Put on your slippers. Oh, Daniel, put his slippers out there, please. Oh my God. Just as I turned around, he just dipped. He just flipped and dipped right back in. Yes, guys. So I just want a quick, you saw him? Yes, he's somewhere right here. We're actually looking at a fish who was being, what you call it now, he was putting on a show, kind of, yeah. But yeah, water is very important. You know, how many glasses or liters or milliliters of water do you drink each day, right? For an adult, if it's not contraindicated, meaning that if you don't have some type of illness, and the doctors say you can't drink a certain amount if you're on water restriction. Some people are, for those people who have heart failure where their heart is filled with water, they may be put on water restriction by their doctors. But if you are a normal person, so to speak, as an adult, you should at least consume at least 2 to 3,000 milliliters of water per day. That is about 2 to 3 liters. And some people can also drink up to a gallon, like myself. When I want to be healthy and my system to be cleansed, and when I'm detoxifying and trying to lose weight or stay in shape rather, I drink at least a gallon. Now there are some people who might say it depends on your body structure, and depending on where in the world you are, if it's a cold state or a hot weather, like the climate. The weather, rather, hot weather or cold weather, right? But climate takes a number of years before it changes, but yeah. So it also depends, some people may say it depends on where you are, you may not need as much water, right? But what I want to tell you today is that according to the biology, your body is made up of at least 80% water. You can imagine our body's made up of 80% water and we're not drowning, right? Our body's made up of 80% water and we're not drowning, right? Can you just think about it? Think about how good God is when he was making us. Remember, he needed water to make us because he had to mix water and the clay so that we could be formed. That is how important water is, right? So also 75% of the earth is water. For those who don't remember geography, 75% of the earth is water. So that's 3/4 of the earth, meaning that is only 1/4 of the earth is dry land. Can you imagine that? Right. All right. So the greater part of your body contains water, like I said, at least 80% of water. Your brain also, if you should do it by body parts, your brain is made up of at least 85% of that 80%, if you understand what I'm trying to say, right? 85% of that 80% of water. Our muscles also is made up of water. We need our muscles to work, right? Dry joints will not knock and can't move. It's just like they might tell us, say, you need WD-40, right? So water is important for even our muscles and joints as well. All right, so also I want you to know that every cell in the human body needs water, guys. What am I trying to tell you? I'm getting there, right? I am getting there. The message is coming. Just wait for it. I'm just letting you know the importance of water, letting you know the biological makeup of the body of water, also the amount of water that is on this earth, right? Or in the world, rather. Now, also, water, you know, just think about it. Just think about water, right? We perspire, we excrete water through our urine, right? Or even perspiration, right? So that's how we lose water each day. So let's say you're someone who perspires a lot, you're losing a lot of water. So even though your body is made up of 80% water, you need to make sure that you're replenishing that in your body to stay hydrated. It is important. And water is also important for homeostasis, to keep the body balanced in terms of temperature and everything, right? Because I'm coming up to the important part of my message today, guys, right? I don't know if you guys can hear me. I don't know if you can hear me. If you can hear me clearly, let me know. Because as you know, I am by the sea. Right, I'm by the sea. So if you can hear me, if you're listening, watching, let me know. Welcome everyone. Motivation Mondays. What's your mood? What motivates you? Today we're talking about the importance of water. Water is a staff of life. All right, so now, problems that will arise when you are deprived of water. Even if water is scarce, you need water to bathe, you need water to brush your teeth, you need water to wash your clothes, you need water to wash your hair, you need water for everything, to cook. So if water is scarce, there is a problem. But the major thing that I'm going to talk about today is with your body, the functions of water when it's removed from your body. Water, you need electrolytes in your system, all of that. So the problems that come about when your body is deprived of water, think about thirst. You get thirsty, right? And if you become real thirsty, then that can lead to dehydration. The entire body becomes uncomfortable, right? You may not know how much or how desperate you needed water until you really become very, very, very thirsty. So that's one problem when you are deprived of water, thirst. Dry eyes. A lot of people don't even think about that. Dry eyes. Itchy eyes, your eyes probably start itching. Sometimes you may think it's allergies, but it not necessarily is an allergy, right? It is because you're lacking water, so you become dry-eyed. And once your eyes become dry, then you're going to have optical issues. You're going to have to be seeing the doctor, okay? It leads to discomfort. Your eyes are gonna start feeling uncomfortable. Fluctuating of blood pressure, again. Get out the water. Why are you swimming in the water? Did I say you're to swim in the water? Did I say you're to swim? I know you was going to do some foolishness. I know you was going to do some nonsense. Why? Sorry about that, guys. Yes. So water when your body's lacking water, it's like, remember I said earlier, homeostasis, so it affects your pressure, the blood pressure. Remember, blood is made up of water as well, and if you don't have enough water, then the blood is gonna start clotting, right? The blood is gonna start clotting, so the blood is not going to be circulating properly, all right? So your blood pressure is affected, it begins to fluctuate, right? It must be, your blood pressure must be good and in stable condition for, you know, your body to be operating or functioning properly. Stop, Malachi. No, none of that. Now, let's talk about the blood clot. Lack of water also leads to blood clot. Just in case you did not know, you need to be drinking your water. Drink your water, right? The human blood is kept healthy, in a healthy shape, when there is adequate water. So once you're hydrated, then your blood should be flowing easily, properly, and not clotting because of lack of water. All right, so if you didn't know that, if somebody has blood clot issues, check with them also. It could be because they are not, I'm not saying that every blood clot is because of dehydration, meaning that your body is lacking water. Malachi, come baby. It could be other things, but you could check with them. If it's not a person who you know has any other ailments, check with them how much water they had for the day or for the week or for the past month. Impaired kidney functions, that's another issue you can have when you're lacking water. Your kidneys start to malfunction. Remember, your kidneys, that's what, where your urine, that helps to produce your urine, you know, that is a part of your body that helps in your urine, the processing of your urine, and to excrete your urine from your body. Okay, so when there's not enough water, kidneys start to malfunction. Now, heart failure. Now, if you've never had heart issues before, again, you might start feeling chest pains. It could be because you're dehydrated, you're lacking water in your system, your body is deprived of water. So you could experience heart failure, okay? Now, constipation, another thing, not a problem, constipation. When your body lacks water, you could be constipated, and if you're not eating enough fiber, but today the topic is about water, so you may want to start drinking enough water or have a high fiber intake in your food. All right, urinary tract infections. A lot of times people may think it's other things that cause urinary tract infections. I have a class, guys, so I'm gonna hurry up. So one of the other problems that can arise from dehydration or lack of water in your body is urinary tract infections, UTIs. So you start experiencing itches down at the private part area. Men probably start experiencing burning. It may not be necessarily STDs, but it could be a fact that they are lacking water. All right? You need water to flush out your system. Okay? Again, infections, that's what caused the UTI. And so water can help to flush out that infection. Headache is another problem. Sometimes you've never experienced headache before, you start to experience headache. It could be that, check yourself, how much water have you drank that day, okay? So these are very important, right? Also, the most drastic thing that can happen because of lack of water is death. You can die, all right? It is said in biology that you can live for at least 40 days without food, but only a number of days without water. Water is vital. Water is more important than food. So you can survive with water by just drinking pure water, right? You can survive by, I'm saying, like if you don't eat food for a very long time, at least up to 40 days, a month and more, you could survive, but without water, you may die, all right? And geography has it that most of Earth's population, study has shown that the highest population of human beings live where there is a body of water. So where you find seas, lakes, rivers, or anything like that, they're like natural water, that is, I must say, you may find a higher population there. Okay, so places like London, Montreal, Chicago, where I used to live, you know, you may find that there is more people located in those areas. All right, guys, so I just want to leave that with you today. So just to know the importance of water. Make sure that you're consuming, if you're an adult, you're consuming at least two liters of water each day. If you're someone who you're not used to it, start practicing by taking a glass of water every hour. You know, just set your alarm.
Let's go.
Set your alarm, start drinking at least a glass of water. So you may say, oh, but I'm at work and I'm gonna have to go to the bathroom very frequently. Well, guess what? Your body will, once you start training your body will start getting used to it, as long as you're not drinking too much at any one time. So you want to balance it. That's just one strategy of starting to make sure that you're drinking enough water, if it's not contraindicated by your doctor based on some other underlying issues. All right, guys, so thank you so much for staying with me today. I hope that you've learned something. And don't forget to share. Share with someone who you think could use this information. All right, guys, so once again, it's your Queen Cleopatra, Nurse Cleopatra today. Hone your health. Motivation Mondays. I'll see you next Thursday at the top at Testimony Thursday. You already know the bottom is so crowded. Peace out, guys. One love.